Stadium, where we're just moments away from kickoff between the Prince George Kodiaks and the Kamloops Broncos. A beautiful tribute to Tom Masich, who unfortunately passed away earlier this week. The Prince George Track and Field Club here to run one final lap in Tom's honor. And a beautiful rendition of O Canada by none other than Christine Midgley. The captains are heading to midfield for the opening coin toss. As mentioned, we're just moments away from kickoff, and we will have kickoff coming up after this. Place Stadium, where the coin has been tossed, and we are just moments away from the opening kickoff between the Prince George Kodiaks and the Kamloops Broncos. Of course, Kodiaks games being powered by the Prestige Treasure Cove Resort. This game being brought to you by BBRD Waste. The Prince George Kodiaks looking for their second win of their inaugural season. The Kamloops Broncos, they're looking for back-to-back victories against the Kodiaks and a perfect sweep of the Prince George Kodiaks in a three-game series this season. However, the last team that Prince George faced for a third time, the Valley Huskers. And that was right here at Masich Place Stadium, where the Prince George Kodiaks earned their first win in franchise history. Which way will this game go? Well, only four quarters of play will tell. We've got a near packed house here at Masich Place Stadium. Of course, fans still filing in through the gates. We've got the College Heights Secondary School drumline also in attendance. They are bringing quite the atmosphere as well. And those who have been paying attention to the Kodiaks, those who have perhaps been here to a game but not here at the moment, you know what the atmosphere is like. And we've got the opening kickoff. The Kamloops Broncos will be kicking off broadcast left to right. The Prince George Kodiaks will be receiving its Marquise Banks and Keon Raymond Jr. back to receive. And here we go. The opening kickoff. Marquise Banks gets it at the 5-yard line, gets past a defender, and gets brought down at the 21-yard line. And Liam Oskowski and his offensive unit will take the field for the first time tonight. The ball will be spotted at the far hash mark, with the Kodiaks going broadcast right to left now. Of course, thank you very much for those tuning in on 99.3 Rewind Radio. This game's also being streamed through BCFC TV, so thank you, whether you're watching it, whether you're listening to it. Thanks for joining us. And Liam Oskowski getting ready to take the first snap of tonight. Three receivers set on either side of him. Empty backfield. Oskowski in the shotgun, drops back, looks right, quick, tries to connect with Marquise Banks, and that goes in and out of his hands as he tries to stretch out to make the reception. That falls incomplete, and it will be second and 10. 14:23 remaining in the first quarter. The The Kodiaks break the huddle. Oskowski gets his offense lined up, and it will be a trips left formation. Three receivers set to the left of Oskowski. Single back formation. Noah Lank in the backfield. Oskowski drops back, steps up, looks to tuck it, makes a few moves, gets some positive yardage, and that is very close to a first down. Ball will be spotted just what looks to be 1 yard short of the first down. It will be third down. And it looks like the jumbo set, the meat of the offense, comes into the formation. And Quinn Newcomb comes in at quarterback. Oskowski on the sideline. Quinn Newcomb, the Dutchess Park Condor product. And he will go in under center. Three backs in the backfield. Newcomb under center. Takes the snap and plunges forward. He's still up and gets some. About 5 yard rush on the play. 13-12 on the clock. And it is a Prince George Kodiaks first down. Ball spotted now, being spotted at the 36-yard line in between the hash marks. First down for Prince George. And Oskowski is back out onto the field. Three receivers to the right of the formation. And Noah Lank, the lone back, in behind Oskowski. Oskowski takes the snap, handoff to Lank. Lank finds a hole, tries to rush through it, plunges, rumbles, and that is a gain of about 8 yards on the play. 12:31 remaining in the opening quarter here at Massage Place Stadium. So second and one. Oskowski still in the shotgun. Two receivers on the weak side of the formation. Handoff to Lank once again, and he plunges forward. And that is another Prince George Kodiaks first down. Ball being spotted just 1 yard short of the 50-yard line inside the Prince George end of the field as they approach midfield. Ball spotted close to the near side hash mark, just inside of it. Oskowski calls his cadence, takes the snap, and goes right back to Noah Lank, and he gets stood up, but gets about 3 yards on the rush. So second and seven now. Kodiaks just a few yards short of midfield. Three receivers to the strong side, the wide side of the field. Oskowski tries to draw the flag, and that he does. Offside on the Kamloops Broncos. Number 45, the guilty culprit on that. Simon Hearn gets drawn offside, takes a hop, skip, and tries to throw himself back onside, but the flags litter the field, and that'll be offside. A 5-yard penalty against the Kamloops Broncos brings the Prince George Kodiaks just 1 yard short of a first down, but now past midfield. William Oskowski stays in for the short yardage play under center I formation. And it's a handoff to Noah Lank, who takes it off tackle, and that is a first down. The Prince George Kodiaks finding some success on the ground, something we haven't seen a lot of this season. We'll see whether it's able to be sustained throughout the course of this game, but so far it is coming up on their side as they now get the ball at the Kamloops 47-yard line. Ball spotted at the near side hash mark. Oskowski back in the shotgun, trips right, and goes right back to Noah Lank. Lank gets into some contact, gets brought down, but that'll be a gain of about 4 yards. Noah Lank showing much of what we saw last year in the high school season here in Prince George as a member of the Dutchess Park Condors. Noah Lank ended up being the BC High School Football AA Offensive Player of the Year as a member of the Condors, a championship team as well. He's finding the ability to make contact but still get some positive yardage after the initial contact. Oskowski drops back, connects to Evan Ingram, and that will be another first down. Oskowski dropped back, found Ingram right there in the pocket over the middle of the field. And Evan Ingram comes up with a first down, and the Kodiak's offense is rolling. Now, we saw some sustainable drives last week by the Kodiak's, but many of them ended up resulting or ending in a turnover. You have Keegan Curtis just there on the other side of the ball, a member of the Kamloops Broncos there in the free safety position as he takes a few steps up in his defensive position. Came up with four interceptions last week. Quick hit to Jerome Erickson near the near side, and he's out for a gain of about 4 yards. So it'll be second and six. 9:04 remaining here in the first quarter. Kodiak's showing some sustainable offense here early. This first drive managed to chew up nearly 6 minutes of the first quarter clock here as they're approaching the red zone in the Kamloops end of the field. Oskowski back in the shotgun. Takes the snap, drops back, looks to his right over the middle, and that's a connection to Jared Annis. Annis trying to get upfield, gets brought down by the tail of his jersey, but looks to be like he might have a gain of a few. Looks to be about 2 yards short of the first down. Noah Schneider comes in on third down. Noah Schneider usually coming in for place kicking. We'll see if the Kodiak's decide to go with a field goal attempt, and I don't believe they will be. It looks like Quinn Newcomb is in at quarterback. He will go under center. Three back formation in the backfield. Newcomb takes a snap, takes a step to the side, and plunges ahead for a gain of enough yardage for another Kodiak's first down. 8:04 remaining here in the opening quarter, and the Prince George Kodiak's continue to move the field, chipping away at the yardage ahead. And they are now just inside the 20-yard line. Ball being spotted at the 16-yard line on the far side hash mark as they're approaching the goal line here. Oskowski back in the formation at quarterback. Noah Lank, the running back, solo running back in the formation. Oskowski drops back. Some pressure up the middle, and he gets brought down by number 16, Maurice Onyemenu of the Kamloops Broncos. Onyemenu leading this defensive unit, that being now his fourth sack on the season. It'll be a loss of about 8 yards on the play, so second and 18. Kodiak's needing to get to the 6-yard line for a first down. 7 minutes remaining here in the first quarter, and it'll be a quads left formation. Four receiver set to the strong side of the formation. Oskowski drops back, looks to his left, still dancing around the pocket, tries to connect, and that falls incomplete to Jared Annis. So third down, ball being spotted at the 24-yard line. So Noah Schneider comes in. It'll be Jerome Erickson, the holder for the field goal opportunity. And the Kodiak's with the opportunity to go ahead to open the scoring here at Massage Place Stadium. Will be a 31-yard field goal attempt for Noah Schneider, the Yorkton, Saskatchewan product. The ball is up and bounces off the upright. Field goal attempt is and that is no good with 6:32 Kamloops Broncos will take over on offense. A disappointing end to the opening offensive series. Looked to be promising by the Kodiaks as they were chipping away at the yardage ahead. But unfortunately, a missed field goal. Noah Schneider ringing it off the upright and falling no good. And the score remains 0-0. 6:32 remaining in the opening quarter. And the officials will be spotting the ball at the 24-yard line. It will be Reed Van Kunit, the quarterback. 6 touchdowns last week against Prince George down in Kamloops. 3 through the air, 3 on the ground. He'll be looking to have a similar impact tonight here in front of Prince George's crowd. And it'll go a handoff to Evan Guizzo, number 11, who rumbles ahead, finds the sideline and gains of about 8 yards. It'll be a flag on the play. It'll be holding against the Kamloops Broncos. So a rumble of 8 yards, but that will come back against the Broncos as they're being called for holding on the play. So it'll be first. It'll be first and 10. With the ball being spotted at the 14-yard line now. Ball, the near side hash mark, 6:11 remaining here in the opening quarter. And Van Kunit breaks the huddle. Single back formation. 3 receivers to the left side in a bunch formation in tight. And it'll be a sweet play to Caleb Sands, and he gets brought down very quickly in behind the line of scrimmage. Number 90, Jason Kratt, the Hixon BC product. So second and even longer for the Kamloops Broncos. We're now under 6 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Ball spotted now at the 10-yard line, just inside the far side hash mark of the field here. And the crowd is rumbling here at Massage Place Stadium. No surprises at all for those who have been paying attention to the Kodiaks. You know this is a loud house to be playing in. Van Kunit drops back, rolls to his right. Still rolling, looks to try to go deep for Colton Meikle, and that ball's incomplete. And almost nearly intercepted by the Kodiaks, number 22, nearly with the interception. But instead, that falls incomplete, and it will be third down for the Broncos. 5:13 remaining in the opening quarter. The punt team in up very tight against their own goal line. We'll see if they concede a safety or whether they opt to try to kick it away. Keon Raymond, Jr., back to receive. He's currently standing on about the 47-yard line inside the Kamloops zone. And it goes snapped, and they will opt to punt it away, and Keon Raymond, Jr. catches it inside the 45 and makes a few moves and is able to get a gain of a few, and the offense will take over at what looks to be the ball being marked at the 36-yard line, I do believe. 4:41. We'll see if the Kodiaks can try to have a very similar sustainable drive that they had to open up this game. Perhaps the only thing they want to change is ending the drive with a few points in their favor. Of course, a missed field goal attempt, bringing off the near side upright here at Massage Place Stadium, keeps the score at 0-0. As Oskowski calls out his cadence, takes the snap, and hands off a stretch play to Noah Lank, and he gets wrapped up. It looks to be a loss of a few yards for the Kodiaks. Noah Lank trying to find the edge on the stretch play as he made his way towards the near side sideline here. Unable to really find a way to cut upfield. And instead, he gets brought down behind the line of scrimmage, a loss of 3 yards on the play, and it'll be second and 13. Just under 4 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Some motion from the receivers towards the right side, the strong side of the formation. Oskowski looks to go deep, tries to connect to Evan Ingram, and that falls incomplete. Tight coverage there from Kamloops as number 8, Logan Ritchie there, foot for foot, step for step, to force the incompletion as it looks to be a quick two and out for the Kodiaks. We'll see if the black and gold have a trick up their sleeve. You see number 16, Quinn Newcomb, in on the formation, but there is a flag being thrown by the head official. It looks like he's trying to count up the number of Kodiaks on the field. And it will be a too many men penalty being called against the Kodiaks, so that will bring the ball back. Still inside the Kamloops zone, and no change in personnel out on the field, but it's Matthew Uriah Mitchell back to punt this ball away. He'll take the snap and he will kick it away, tries to aim for the coffin corner, and that bounces off a member of the Kodiaks and will be no yards on the play. It gets recovered at the 21-yard line, but the officials will surely be moving that ball even further ahead for Reed Van Konant to start this offensive series. 3:29 remaining in the first quarter. The Broncos offense on the field for the second series of this matchup. It'll be first and 10 from the 35-yard line. Ball spotted on the near side hash mark. I formation in behind Van Konant, but the fullback motions over to the right side. Van Konant, quick handoff to Guizzo. Guizzo plunges forward. He's still up, and he's carrying a trio of Kodiaks defenders with him, and he gets brought down at the 47-yard line. So it will be a first down for the Kamloops Broncos. Of course, the Broncos without their usual starting running back, Cameron Gogorchik, not in the lineup tonight, being the leading rusher for this offense with 53 rushes for 226 yards and 3 touchdowns. Instead, it's been Evan Guizzo the last few weeks, and he seems to be handling it quite well early on against the Prince George Kodiaks. He finds yet another hole, and he gets brought down now inside the Prince George end of the field, past midfield. And gets brought down at about the Prince George 50-yard line. 2:20 and counting remaining here in the first quarter. Kamloops deciding to stick to the ground fairly early, and Guizzo's been averaging close to, if not over, a first down per rush. Konant drops back, looks to pass, hits the flat, number 87. He gets tripped up but stays upright, and he's still running 30 and gets forced out at the 30. Number 87 for the Kamloops Broncos looks to be Thomas Jeeves, the slot receiver, the furthest close or closest inset receiver on the formation. Comes up with a quick out route into the flats, and Van Konant hits him and gets a huge gain to put the Broncos now inside the 30-yard line as they're approaching the goal line. Hand off to Guizzo. He finds a hole and gets brought down. Gain of a few yards. Brings the ball to about the 25-yard line as he rushes towards the near side of the field. It will be second and 5. Guizzo in behind Van Konant. Konant looking, scanning the defense, drops back, looks to his left, trying to connect to number 83, gets upright and looks as though he may have brought that one down. Managed to absorb the contact as he leaped up trying to make the reception, and he was able to focus enough on the ball to secure it, bring it in, and that is a first down for the Kamloops Broncos. Final few seconds ticking away here in the opening quarter. Crowd trying to support their defense, but Van Konant hands off to Guizzo. Guizzo finds a hole, plunges forward, and looks to get wrapped up just short of the 5-yard line. And that will be the final play of the opening quarter. So we will step away for a quick moment. We'll have more action coming up after this as we get the second quarter underway here at Massage Place Stadium.
At Collins Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds.
So there was one extra play being played there before the actual official end of the first quarter. So my apologies to those listening on the radio that weren't able to see what was going on. And apologies to those who are streaming through BCFC TV. They were questioning what was going on. There was an extra play at the end of the first quarter. But now we do officially have the second quarter getting underway. Second quarter being brought to you by Lally Electric. And it will be the Kamloops Broncos lining up for a field goal attempt. Third down, and they're lining up for a close to a 21-yard field goal attempt. It will be number 29, Cohen Freeze, looking for the opening points tonight. And ball snapped, it's up, and that is good as the Kamloops Broncos open the scoring 3-0. So now we will take another break as we have the kickoff coming up after this. Cohen Freeze with the opening points, and here he gets the kickoff away to the Prince George Kodiaks. Keon Raymond Jr. will make the return as he takes his time, waits for a hole to open up, and gets brought down at the 30-yard line. 14-37 remaining here in the second quarter. You're listening to Kodiak's Games being powered by the Prestige Treasure Cove Resort right here on 99.3 Rewind Radio. Also, thanks to those who are tuning in via video stream on BCFC TV. Kodiaks will take their first offensive drive of the second quarter. Kamloops Broncos opening the scoring with a 21-yard field goal attempt by Cohen Fries. That was good as they're up 3-0. Oskowski takes the snap and a handoff to Noah Lank, who plunges forward, tries to find a hole and finds about 3 yards. It'll be second down for the Kodiaks. Kodiaks break the huddle. Three receivers set towards the near side of the field, the strong side of the field, with ball being spotted on the far side hash mark. Oskowski calls his cadence, drops back, looks over the middle and finds, or that actually falls incomplete. It looked to be a wide open Matthew Uriah K. Mitchell coming over in a slant route towards the hash mark, but that goes through his hands as he's unable to secure it, and it'll be a quick two and out for the Kodiaks as the punt team comes out onto the field. Jack Cochran back to punt, starts running towards the near side of the field, trying to find an edge. And that is no good. Tried to go with a keeper, little trick play on the play. So Jack Cochran just several yards short on the design keeper on the third down punt play. And that is a turnover on downs as the Kamloops Broncos take over on offense. A questionable call, you could say, for the Kodiaks is ball being spotted inside their own end of the field, now giving the Broncos pretty reasonable field position as their offense takes over now. 12:55 remaining here in the second quarter. And Conan hands off, and he gets stacked up in behind the line of scrimmage. Evan Guizzo unable to pass the line of scrimmage, and there is a flag on the play. It looks to be some extracurriculars following the whistle of the previous play, and it may be coming up against Zach Cormier, number 93 of the Kodiaks. Officials meeting up, discussing the call, and they will be walking against the Kodiaks.
Well, the flag on the field was a penalty against the Kodiaks. That's going to cost the Kodiaks in the yard.
So the Broncos will now be given the ball first down now, ball being spotted on the 20-yard line. Near side hash mark as players come off and new ones come on for the Kodiaks. The Broncos break the huddle. Watch number 17, Colton Meikle, in the slot on the near side of the field. And a handoff to Evan Guizzo. Guizzo gets brought down, a gain of a few yards on the play, ever able to chip away a little bit at this Kodiaks defense, but it'll be second and looks to be 8. So a gain of a few yards. Guizzo gets brought down. It'll be second down for the Broncos. Coming up, 12 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Brought to you by Lally Electric. Benkonen in the shotgun. Takes a snap. Draws back. Looks to his left. Looks for the end zone. Colton Meikle. And that ball's incomplete. No good. And there's no flag on the play either. Strong defensive coverage there by Keon Raymond Jr., forcing the incompletion as Benkonen tried to connect with the sure-handed Colton Meikle. Meikle with three touchdown receptions last week, trying to keep that connection going tonight here at Massage Place Stadium. But that falls incomplete. It will be third down as the Broncos line up for a second field goal attempt of the night. Cohen Freeze slightly further than the last field goal attempt. 25-yard field goal attempt here. It goes up, and that is good as well, as the Broncos now take a 6-0 lead with 11:22 remaining here in the second quarter. More second quarter action brought to you by Lally Electric coming up after this break.
Collins Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds and 36-inch TVs. Suites also include a mini fridge and
Kodiaks, and it'll be Maurice Banks back to receive the kickoff as he finds some room to maneuver, and he gets brought down just past the 30-yard line. And the Kodiaks end of the field. Ball will get spotted at the 32-yard line to start this offensive series for the Kodiaks. ...11:16 remaining in the second quarter, as the Kodiaks break their huddle. Ball spotted on the far side hash mark, 32-yard line. Oskowski with a trips right formation. Three receivers towards the near side of the field. Jerome Erickson motions through the backfield, and Oskowski tries to connect to Evan Ingram, but that's just a little too far for number 19. That ball's incomplete. Second and 10 for the Kodiaks, with 10:53 remaining here in the second quarter. Player to watch on the defensive side for the Broncos, number 32, Keegan Curtis, had four interceptions last week against the Kodiaks, I believe matching a season total for the Kamloops Broncos in franchise history. He has seven this season already. Oskowski, little dump pass to Noah Lank out of the backfield. He gets wrapped up and brought down by number 16, Maurice Anyamenu. Curtis proving to be a ball hawk for the Broncos defense last week. A number of deep pass attempts by the Kodiaks, and you can almost start to put money on Curtis being right there with it, as he was just tracking, it seemed, every single pass thrown from the black and gold. Third down, Kay Mitchell back to punt for the Kodiaks. And Caleb Sens, the return man for the Broncos, as he'll make the catch and gets stood up, gets a few yards, tries to tiptoe, does some dancing, and gets brought down just short of midfield. We're now under 10 minutes to go here until halftime, with the Kamloops Broncos leading 6-0. A flag on the play. There is a flag down. a block from behind going against the Kamloops Broncos. So that will move them back. So ball will get spotted now just short of the 40-yard line on their end of the field. Just inside the near side hash mark. Van Konen in the shotgun. Cleezo lone back in behind number one, the quarterback. Colton Meikle, the slot receiver on the far side of the field. It'll be a quick handoff to Cleezo, who gets wrapped up very quickly. Number 27, Nick Tremblay with the tackle. Tremblay being a stud on defense for these Kodiaks, coming up with a number of tackles for losses in this season. And he comes up with another, taking down Guizzo in behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of 2 yards on the play. The ball now getting spotted at the 38-yard line. Smack dab between the hash marks. Reed Van Konen in shotgun. Pulls his cadence, drops back, looks over the middle, trying to connect to number 19. And he gets brought down by number 20, Tegan Morin. But number 19, Brock Dufort, the receiver on the play, comes up with a reception, and that will be a first down for the Kamloops Broncos as they near midfield now here at Massage Place Stadium. The lights are on tonight. Just over 8 minutes remaining here in the second quarter, and the Broncos have a first down on their own 54-yard line in between the hash marks. So a balanced field on either side of the center. Trips right on either side. Van Konen, quick hit to Chris Finden, the PG product, who cuts back towards the sideline, tries to make a move and gets brought down, but there is a flag being thrown by the official along the sideline. We'll see what ends up being the penalty call. Flag was thrown in the midst of Finden being tackled on the play. We've got 7:38 remaining here in the second quarter. The Kamloops Broncos currently leading the Prince George Kodiaks 6-0, and it looks like the penalty will go against the Broncos. Corbin Brown, number 52, comes off the field for the Kodiaks, the Vanderhoof BC product. It'll be a holding call against the Broncos. So the ball will get spotted back inside the Kamloops end, but only by a few inches. As the ball is just inside the Kamloops end of the field, just a few yards short of the 55-yard line. And Reed Van Konen, the quarterback for the Broncos, breaks the huddle, calls out his cadence, takes a snap, and it's a quick handoff to Evan Guizzo. Guizzo rushes up the middle, breaks some tackles, and gets brought down. And looks like he may have enough for a Kamloops Broncos first down. And indeed, looks like it will be just short. So 1 yard short of the first down, second and one. Now past midfield, ball being spotted at the 46-yard line. Bunched receivers towards the left of the formation. Guizzo gets the handoff, and he gets wrapped up and brought down. And it looks like there is a fumble on the play, and number three of the Prince George Kodiaks, Matthew Watson. But it looks like there may have been a whistle. Looks as though Guizzo may have been down on the play. And that fumble will be a no-go for the Kodiaks, despite their strongest efforts to try to sell it to the officials and all those in attendance here at Massage Place Stadium. But it will be a tackle for a loss, nonetheless, by number 93, Zach Cormier of the Prince George Kodiaks. So it will be third down now. It is now third down. number 87, Thomas Jeeves, back to punt for the Kamloops Broncos. We'll see if the Broncos decide to have a tricky sleeve on this one. And Jeeves takes the kick, end-over-end punt. Keon Raymond Jr. to receive, catches it just in past the 10-yard line, finds a hole, breaks loose. He's still going, trying to find the edge against the Kamloops Broncos, and he gets brought down on the far side of the field, and there is a flag on the play. Found a hole, was just trying to find the edge, and he gets brought out at the 35-yard line, but there is a flag on the play. With 5:55 remaining here in the second quarter, looked as though he was going to get brought down fairly early in the return, but somehow managed to find a crease. And that will be a penalty going against the Kamloops Broncos as the officials move the ball up, and ball will get spotted at the 51-yard line, 4 yards away from midfield here at Massage. And the Kodiaks offense will break the huddle and rush up to the ball with, as mentioned, 5:55 remaining here in the quarter. Oskowski looks towards the sideline, gets some signals. Receivers motioning out from the backfield. A trips right formation. Three receivers to the right side. Oskowski drops back, looks over the middle, tries to connect with number 87. And wouldn't you know it, number 32, Keegan Curtis, comes up with an interception for the Kamloops Broncos. But number 87 of Prince George, TJ Nyberg, is still down on the field. Tried to make a diving effort for the reception, but he is still down on the field as the training staff comes out to tend to him. An interception by number 32, Keegan Curtis. Believe that's his 8th interception on the season. After 4 interceptions last week down in Kamloops, he comes up with another interception. And the Broncos will take over on offense. Member of the Kodiaks still down on the field as he's being tended to by training staff. So we'll step away and take a quick break. When we get back, more second quarter action here at Massage Place Stadium.
At Collins Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds and 36-inch TVs. Suites also include a mini fridge and other kitchen appliances to make your stay as comfortable as possible. During your stay in Pilot Mound, visit Weiser's Restaurant, our attached family-friendly restaurant and bar. It is the perfect location to host group meals, dine with the family, or unwind after a hockey game. Come in and meet our friendly staff offering daily specials on food and drinks, wing night Wednesdays, buffet Fridays, and multiple TVs to watch the game. Weiser's is the place to be. Collins Hotel and Weiser's Restaurant and Bar, located across the street from Blackjack Stewart Arena off Highway 3 in Pilot Mound.
Leading the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 6-0 with 5:33 remaining here in the second quarter. TJ Nyberg of the Kodiaks getting helped up off the field. Looks to be favoring a lower body injury following a attempt to try to make a diving reception, which ended up resulting in an interception by number 32, Keegan Curtis of the Kamloops Broncos. As a result, the Broncos will take over on offense. Nyberg able to get off to the Kodiak sideline. And the Broncos take over on offense. Reed Van Conant breaks the huddle in shotgun. Receiver motions out of the backfield. Van Conant takes a snap, a toss play over to Evan Guizzo towards the right side of the formation. He gets a rush of several yards, looks to be about 8-yard gain on the play. It'll be second down. It'll be second and three. So a rush of about 7 yards on the play. Second and three now as the ball spotted on the 51-yard line on the far side hash mark. 4:45 remaining here in the second quarter. Minkonit back in the shotgun. Evan Guizzo, lone back in the backfield, steps up. It will be a passing play. Minkonit tries to get the edge, does some dancing, gets out and escapes the pocket, looks towards the sideline, gets pushed out, comes up with a first down, but a rush of several yards, probably again closer to 20 yards on the play as he's able to do some dancing in the backfield, break loose of a defender off coming on off the edge to put some pressure, but instead Minkonit comes up with a nifty little first down rush. Broncos with the ball spotted on the 42-yard line, far side hash mark. We've got three receivers on either side, empty backfield. Minkonit takes the snap, looks towards his left. Quick hit to Sens, but he's unable to hold it, and that falls incomplete with just over 4 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Sens likely hearing some footsteps coming up from behind him as he dropped the quick hitch route. And it'll be second and 10 for the Broncos. Broncos break the huddle. Look at the formation. Chris Finden, the far side receiver along the line. Colton Meikle coming up there in the slot. Minkonit looks, drops back, does some rushing, looking to run the ball again, but he gets brought down, wrapped up by number 27, Nick Tremblay for the sack. And that is a loss and third down on the play. So the punt team comes out onto the field for the Broncos. It'll be number 6, Marquise Banks, back to receive the punt as he trots out to the 10-yard line, 15-yard line in anticipation of the punt. And there's a flag being thrown. As a member of the Kamloops Broncos runs off towards the sideline, there'll be too many men against Kamloops. So that will bring the ball even further back, aiding the Kodiaks. So ball gets brought back by the officials all the way to the Kamloops 53-yard line. Guizzo is onside, so he'll be looking to track this one down, trying to go for an onside. And the ball gets kicked away end over end. Banks with the return, and he gets wrapped up and brought down at the 30-yard line as the Kodiaks offense comes out onto the field. Oskowski trying to piece together a scoring drive as PG being held scoreless. So I mentioned earlier something about Kamloops Broncos currently leading 6-0 with 2:35 remaining here in the half. Oskowski takes the snap, drops back, looks, and connects with one of his receivers along the far sideline. Looks to be number Number 19, Evan Ingram, the Calgary, Alberta product. Kodiaks are now in a quick offense, no huddle offense, I should say. Reach the two-minute mark of the second quarter. Oskalki calls out his cadence, takes a snap, drops back some pressure from the defense. Quick hit to Jared Annis. And that might be a gain of even just a few yards on the play as the Kodiaks rush the no-huddle offense. Kodiaks keep the same personnel out onto the field. Oskalski directs the offense. Noah Schneider in at running back. Oskalski takes the snap, looks over the middle, looks for a quick hit to number 84, Jared Annis. And that's a little bit of a stretch route there as that brings the Kodiaks past midfield with the ball getting marked at the 44-yard line. But it looks like there may be a penalty going against the Kodiaks. Officials say that was a no catch. So no penalty on the play. Instead, the officials were calling that a no catch instead. And as a result, it brings up third down as Kay Mitchell, number 17 for the Kodiaks, back to kick this one away to Caleb Sens, number 88. Kay Mitchell, end-over-end punt. He gets it away, and that will skip back towards the 20-yard line. Sens trying to find the edge. He finds the sideline but gets wrapped up and brought down just past the 50-yard line. So 1:42 remaining here in the second quarter, and the Broncos are right back on offense. So Broncos will start their offensive drive with 1:41 to work with at the 53-yard line in their own end of the field. Far side hash mark. Looks to be an empty backfield, but you see Evan Guizzo, the in-tight slot receiver there. Then Conant will drop back, step up, try to maneuver the pocket as he'll roll to his right side, tries to connect and looks to be a connection to Guizzo, and it looks like they may call that a completion. And that may even be enough for a... I think that might just be a few yards short of a first down, actually. So second and two past the midway mark. The ball being spotted at the 53-yard line. Far side hash mark. Menconin, three receivers to either side, and it's a handoff to Guizzo coming in off the slot, and he rushes for enough for a first down, and that moves the sticks. 1:14 remaining in the second quarter. First down. The officials will be spotting the ball at the 44-yard line. Menconin drops back, gets some pressure from the defense, finds a wide-open Evan Guizzo, who's got some real estate to rush against, finds the sideline, gets pushed out. Well, that will be yet another first down for the Broncos as Menconin got some pressure but found a wide-open Evan Guizzo rushing towards the backside of the formation, and he had plenty of room to run up against, racking up the yaks, you could say. We're now 43.6 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So first down, ball spotted at the 16-yard line, far side hash mark. And the Broncos in scoring position, looking to add to their 6-0 lead so far. Kankonen drops back, scans the defense. He's on the run again. And Fulton throws the ball away, sensing some pressure from number 90, Jason Kratt from the Kodiaks. And that forces a 2nd and 10 as Vanconet throws the ball away out of bounds. So 2nd and 10. The Broncos break the huddle. Guizzo now in the backfield. Watch to see a run play here, perhaps, from the Broncos as Vancona drops back. And it will be a passing play, and he's on the run yet again. Flag in the backfield, and Nick Tremblay comes up with a swatted pass down. Vancona trying to throw the ball, but Tremblay swats that one down to the turf. And there is a flag in the backfield. We'll wait to see what the penalty is being called. And it looks like it was a pass interference call against the Kamloops Broncos, but the Kodiaks opt to decline that one, forcing a third down as Cohen Fries comes back out onto the field looking for a perfect 3-3 on field goal attempts. This will be a 24-yard field goal attempt. Ball is up, and that is good. A perfect 3-for-3, and Cohen Fries responsible for all 9 points on the Kamloops side of the scoreboard as they lead 9-0 with 24 seconds remaining. We'll step away, take a quick 30-second break. When we get back, the Kodiaks take over on offense. Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium, where we've got 24 seconds remaining here in the second quarter before halftime. Kamloops kicks the ball away to the Kodiaks, and it will be Maurice Banks returning the kickoff as he's trying to find a hole, and he gets brought down from behind by Evan Guizzo, and there is a flag on the play.
Marcus Banks runs the ball back for the Kodiaks to about the 30, and there is a flag on the play.
And it looks like there is a member of the Kodiaks also down on the field as the trainer rushes out onto the field to tend to the injured player. So 17 and a half seconds. So, and it looks like the flag will be a holding call against the Kodiaks. As the training staff still tends to the injured player. So we will take a break. For the player, we'll be back with the Kodiaks on offense to wrap up the second quarter.
Off the field, it might be very
Kodiak's offense now back out onto the field. 17 and a half seconds remaining as the injured Kodiak is now to the sideline. Number 92, Evan Patrick, injured on the previous play. Liam Oskowski, quarterback for the black and gold, looking to find some points in the final few seconds here. Noah Lank, a handoff, and he gets wrapped up by the collar of his own jersey, and that is a sure sign horse collar tackle against number 16, Maurice Onyemenu. It'll be a penalty, a very obvious penalty against the Kamloops Broncos as Onyemenu tries to doubt the penalty, but not sure when how you can deny what just happened when you've got a handful of cloth and player being flung down by his collar, as the Kodiaks will take over or get the automatic first down. So the play or ball being spotted at the 35-yard line as I try to gather my thoughts. My apologies. 11.2 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Trips right, three receivers set towards the near side of the field. Oskowski drops back, a quick hit to Jerome Erickson. And that's Erickson's first reception of the night. A gain of about 6 yards on the play with 4.3 seconds remaining. We'll see if the Kodiaks go for a Hail Mary attempt here to close out the first half of play as the final few seconds will tick away. Kamloops up 9-0, but the Kodiaks have one more play before halftime. We'll see if they try to go for some points here as Oskowski will just hand off to Noah Lank. Noah Lank will rumble towards the sideline, stay upright, and he'll get brought down to short of the 50-yard line as the Kamloops Broncos head into halftime with a 9-0 lead over the Prince George Kodiaks. We will take a break. When we get back, we are going to have the halftime show. We'll recap a little bit of what happened here in the first half, and we'll also have the out-of-town scoreboard with my man JD back at 99.3 Rewind Radio Studios. story of the half, and I don't think I need to say any more than what I'm about to say. Kamloops Broncos currently leading 9-0, and if I were to recap the half, I would only need to say two words, and that is Cohen Freeze, number 29 of the Kamloops Broncos, coming up with a perfect 3-for-3 on field goal attempts, as perhaps some positive side on the defensive side for the Prince George Kodiaks, able to come up with some solid stops to, despite some good movement from the Kamloops Broncos offense, to push the ball into the scoring zone against the Kodiaks. The Kodiaks defense able to stand tall and force third down, resulting in the 9 points we see on the Kamloops side. On the offensive side for the Prince George Kodiaks, decent drives here and there, but ultimately struggling to find those sustainable drives in the first half of play here at Massage Place Stadium. So we'll see how the second half rolls out. It's still a fairly close game between the two sides, 9-0. It's not the 10-10 score we saw last week down in Kamloops at halftime, where both sides came away with a touchdown and field goal through the first 30 minutes of play. Instead, Broncos with all the points, Prince George held scoreless through the first two quarters of play here at Massage Place Stadium. We've got some minor football players out on the field giving some halftime entertainment to all those in attendance here at Massage Place Stadium. We want to, of course, thank all of those that are tuning in on 99.3 Rewind Radio, as well as those who are watching our stream on BCFC TV. We will have the out-of-town scoreboard coming up, but first, we're going to take a break.
So a couple of our sponsors that I'd like to mention together, because they have to go hand in hand, do include Crossroads Brewery. Crossroads and DDRD for their continued support.
lucky enough that it, like, died off. Otherwise, like, play-by-play would have been really interesting in the first quarter. Make it quick. And it may need to be shorter than that, but I'll do what I can, and I'll let you know once we get into it.
Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium, where the Kamloops Broncos currently lead the Prince George Kodiaks by a score of 9-0. We want to thank all those for tuning in on 99.3 Rewind Radio, as well as streaming on BCFC TV. Some stats from the opening half. Prince George completing 7 of 13 passing attempts for 42 yards, rushing for 61 yards on 12 attempts. As for the Broncos, completing 6 for 9 for 89 yards. And they, on the ground, rushing 14 times for 66 yards. We've got the third quarter coming up after this.
Finish the coin toss, so we'll get underway momentarily.
Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium for some BCFC football action between the Prince George Kodiaks and the Kamloops Broncos. The Broncos currently leading 9-0 after the first two quarters of play. We'll see how this second half, how the story gets told here between these two clubs. This is the third and final meeting between these two teams. The Kamloops Broncos, a perfect 2-0 so far in this series. These two teams having played last weekend down in Kamloops, and that was a very lopsided score, 47-17, a victory for the Broncos. And turnovers were definitely the tail of the tape in that one. Five turnovers by the Prince George Kodiaks. Keegan Curtis with four interceptions for the Broncos, and Reed Van Konen with six touchdowns as the quarterback for the Broncos. Three through the air and three on the ground, but it's just been field goals so far for the Broncos tonight as Noah Schneider gets ready to kick this one away. This kickoff being brought to you by DMC Chartered Accountants. As the ball or play is whistled in, Schneider kicks this one away, and the third quarter is now underway. Caleb Sands with the return finds a gap and sprints all the way up just past the 40-yard line to get this second half underway here in Prince George. Reed Van Konen and the offense for the Kamloops Broncos taking the field for the first time in this second half here at Massage Place Stadium. The lights are on, the crowd is packed and loud and ready to get another half of football up and running here in Prince George. The inaugural season for the Prince George Kodiaks as the Broncos break their huddle. Looks to be a four down lineman set for the Kodiaks on defense. Van Konen takes a snap. Little play action, rolls out, and that gets nearly picked off by number 22, Aiden Simpson of the Kodiaks, but instead that falls incomplete with 14:19 remaining here in the third quarter, brought to you by Forest Power Sports. Be second and 10 for the Broncos. Ball being spotted on the 43-yard line on the far side hash mark. Van Konen drops back, looks to pass, steps up in the pocket, tucks it. He's running, gets past the linebackers, and gets brought down from behind for a first down for the Broncos as they now pass the midfield mark here at Massage Place Stadium. It will be first down from the Prince George 50-yard line. So Van Konen showing his ability to scan the defense and feel the pressure and tuck the ball and come up with some positive yardage on his own two legs. And that gets the Broncos in past midfield with 13:20 remaining here in the third quarter. First and 10. Van Konen in the shotgun. Directs traffic from his receivers. Play action, looks over the middle to number 19, who gets tripped up, but as a completed pass. Brock Dufour with the reception on the play, and that moves the chains for another first down for the Broncos as the ball gets spotted at the 36-yard line in between the two hash marks. 12:40 remaining. Broncos up 9-0 over the Prince George Kodiaks. And Konen takes a snap. It's a handoff now to Guizzo, and he storms the middle and gets brought down a gain of about 2 yards. And that'll be a second down for the Broncos. The Broncos break the huddle for this second down play. Looking to get 8 yards out of this play to get a first down. Ball spotted on the far side hash mark. Mancona takes the snap, drops back, looks to his left, but rolls to his right. Decides to tuck it, and he's away rolling on his own 2 feet. And he runs out of bounds. Gain of enough for a first down. Gain of about 12 yards on the play, I would say. And that gets the Kamloops Broncos a first down with the ball being marked at about the 16-yard line. Broncos looking for their first touchdown of tonight as they now are inside the 20-yard line. And Conant takes a snap. It's a handoff back to number 11, Evan Guizzo, who gets wrapped up and brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Big defensive stop. Guizzo forced to try to cut up. Some pressure coming off the edge, and Jason Kratt comes up. The defensive lineman for the Kodiaks comes up with another tackle behind the line of scrimmage to force second and long. The ball now back at the 20-yard line inside the Prince George end of the field. Broncos looking to get the ball down to the 6-yard line for a first down. And Conant takes a snap, drops back in the shotgun, and he tucks it away, looking for the edge. He finds some room, directing some blockers, gets tripped up and brought down by number 36. Coulter Cannon with the tackle for Prince George, but the Broncos able to chip away at some of the yardage. Third and short now, as it looks like the Broncos offense will remain out onto the field. Look to be going for it on this short yardage play. We'll watch to see Evan Guizzo, who's currently in the slot receiver position. Mancona goes in under center for short yardage, plunges forward. Will he have enough? Gets stacked up fairly quickly. It looks like he may have the yard that he's looking for to get a first down. And that, I'll wait to see what the officials end up calling, but they're looking to spot the ball.
Yeah, they say it's first down.
And that will be a first down for the Broncos. Van Conant getting some play direction from his sideline as the Broncos huddle up. Ball now at the 5-yard line. So first and goal for the Broncos. A bunch formation. Two running backs in the backfield. And some miscue from the backfield as Vancona tried to hand off to his left side, tries to take it himself, but gets it down to about the goal 1-yard line. So a little miscue from the backfield as Vancona went one direction, but the backfield went to the right side. Vancona, some quick thinking, decides to tuck it away and rumbles it down to about the 2-yard line as the Broncos still looking for their first touchdown in tonight's matchup. And Conant back under center, decides to roll it towards the edge and plunging for the goal line and looks to be kept out of the end zone as the defense comes up with a strong front. Van Conant had 3 rushing touchdowns from very similar distances last week down in Kamloops. Looking for another tonight, and the Kodiaks defense saw that one coming as they read him trying to creep around the edge and stacked him up and brought him down, as it's now third down and short for the Broncos. Vancona tries to plunge again, looking for some short yardage, and the Kodiaks look to see. Kodiaks come up with a big goal line stand to keep the Broncos out of the end zone. And the Kodiaks offense will take over on offense, as they very quickly rush out onto the field to get this offensive drive up and running. a strong defensive front from the Kodiaks, and that forces a turnover on downs. But the Broncos just inches away from scoring. Instead, Kodiaks keep this a 9-point game with 7:56 remaining in the third quarter, brought to you by Forest Power Sports. Kodiaks go with an I formation, pushed up against their own end zone as Oskowski calls the cadence, some pressure up the middle. Noah Lank gets the handoff as he rushes up the middle. Tries to keep his feet going, but gets pushed back. We'll see where forward progression gets him, as it looks like he might be getting marked at the 4-yard line. So second and 6. Kodiak still pushed up against their own goal line. The 7:10 remaining here in the third quarter. Oskowski now in the shotgun. A little more room for him. Calls the snap, gets the snap, looks over the middle and tries to connect with number 19, Evan Ingram, but that falls incomplete, as that will be third down now. As the Kodiaks look to send out their punt team, the offense coming out. We'll see if the Kodiaks decide to kick this one away or whether they look to concede the 2 points to make this an 11-point game. Number 88, Caleb Sens, back to receive the punt from number 17, Matthew Uriah K. Mitchell from the Kodiaks, who's about midway into his own end zone, and Kay Mitchell will concede the safety. So another 2 points going Kamloops' way as they now lead 11-0 with 6:34 remaining here in the third quarter from Prince George. And it looks like the Broncos offense will immediately take over. So we'll get this offensive series up and running fairly quickly.
Still no majors scored this game. Kamloops is looking for their first change here. Brisbane, of course, looking for their.
So we're coming up on. We're coming up on the midway mark of the third quarter. We've yet to have any majors scored tonight. Broncos leading 11-0 following the conceded safety by Matthew Uriah K. Mitchell from Prince George, with the third down forcing the Kodiaks into their own end zone. The Broncos take over on offense from the 35-yard line. Van Conant. Play action pass over to Sens over the middle. Little leaping catch from Sens, and he comes up with a first down reception for Kamloops. So that will move the sticks with the ball getting spotted at the 47-yard line. Far side hash mark for the Broncos. First and 10. We're under 6 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. And Conant in the shotgun. Trips right formation, hands off to Evan Guizzo, who finds a hole and splits the D and gets brought down, tripped up just past midfield. Will get brought down around the 50-yard line. And that'll be another first down for Kamloops as they're chipping away at this Kodiaks defense. 5:22 remaining here in the third quarter, first and 10. Broncos being spotted the ball at the 49-yard line. Far side hash mark as they break their huddle. Van Conant in the shotgun as he's directing his receivers, calling some audibles. Takes the snap, and it's a quick hitch to Colton Meikle. Meikle trying to get to the sideline, and looks to be a gain of a few yards. Not the big, deep pass connection we're used to seeing between Reed Van Conant and Colton Meikle, but Meikle able to come up with a few yards there on the designed quick hitch route. And it'll be second and 7 for the Broncos. Ball spotted at the 46-yard line. 4:12 remaining in the third quarter. And Conant pulls the snap. Drops back. He gets brought down, but there is a flag in the backfield. Van Conant looked to get tripped up, and it looks like the penalty will be going against the Kamloops Broncos. So the sack will stand. Number 41 for Prince George. Caden Smith coming up with the celebration as he is able to get a hand on the foot of Van Conant to trip him up and force the sack. And that will bring up a third down for Kamloops. As the special teams units will come out onto the field. Keon Raymond Jr. will be the returner on this play as he goes back towards his own 20-yard line. Thomas Jeeves back to punt this punt away. The Australian from the land down under. You can see his Aussie style way of kicking the ball away as he approaches this one. An end over end punt as Keon Raymond nears his 10-yard line, makes the catch, and immediately starts to head towards the near side sideline, who runs into a wall of Kamloops Broncos and gets whistled down at the 26-yard line. 3:13 remaining here in the third quarter. It'll be a penalty against Kamloops.
Well, the ball does go against Kamloops.
It looks like it will be a replay of third down as both teams come back out onto the field. It'll be Maurice Banks now back to return this time around for Prince George as he stands around his own 20-yard line. We'll get to see that Aussie style kick once again as Jeeves back to kick this one away as he stands at his own 39-yard line. He'll take the snap and kick this one away. Maurice Banks will step up, make the catch, and immediately no yards flag being thrown by the official along the far sideline. So that will give the Kodiaks some good field position to start this offensive drive with 2:42 remaining here in the third quarter. So the Kodiaks offense will take over at the 40-yard line. Oskowski takes the snap, drops back, looks to go deep, trying to find Keon Raymond Jr., tries to go up, and that falls incomplete. Keon Raymond Jr. getting some action on the offensive side as looks like Oskowski a little slow to get up following that as he gets helped up by a member of his offensive line. Keon Raymond Jr. has spent some time during his playing career as a receiver, being a dual-use player on either side of the ball. He comes up with some offensive action and the intended target on the previous play, but unable to come up with the reception, as it will be second and 10 for the Kodiaks. Oskowski calls his cadence, drops back in the shotgun, steps up, some pressure coming off the edge, and he'll decide to tuck and run it himself, and he'll rumble up to the 49-yard line, just short of the first down. So that will be a third down, but this looks like there is a flag in the backfield and will be going against the Kodiaks, it looks like. 1:47 remaining here in the third quarter. We'll be holding against the Prince George Kodiaks, so that will push them back. That'll be a 10-yard penalty going against the Kodiaks, so that will be second and 20 now. So it would have been a third and short play had that play stood, which would have put the Kodiaks in an interesting position, being held to the decision of whether they go for it and risk the Broncos taking over in their own end of the field if things didn't go their way. But instead, a penalty going against Prince George, and they will have second and 20 now. Oskowski, single back formation. Oskowski takes the snap, drops back. Quick hit to Keon Raymond Jr., who decides to cut back in towards the middle of the field and tries to do some dancing with the Kamloops Broncos, but they're one step ahead of them as they bring him down to force a third down. Just over a minute to play here in the third quarter. The Kodiaks unable to piece together a sustainable drive on offense as their unit comes to the sideline. It will be third down. Matthew Uriah K. Mitchell, number 17, back to punt this ball away. And Caleb Sens, a speedster on this Kamloops Broncos team, back to return. He'll try to find the edge against this cover team with a booming kick coming from K. Mitchell. And immediately Sens tries to get the edge towards the sideline. He's got the edge. K. Mitchell trying to cut him off. Sends a little spin move and gets past the midfield mark and gets the offense some very good field position. As the Broncos will take over on offense at the 41-yard line in the Prince George end of the field. Caleb Sens just showcasing that speed that he has, able to get to the edge of the field, trying to cut up field. Sometimes he's able to, but in that time it even takes him to get to the sideline, he's already covered about 20 yards of turf. And as a result, it gives the Broncos offense very good field position as they're already inside the Prince George end of the field. As Vancone takes a snap, a little toss to Guizzo. Guizzo gets tripped up behind the line of scrimmage by number 27, Nick Tremblay, a staple of the Kodiaks defense. And that will bring the conclusion of the third quarter. We'll see. I learned my lesson in the first half. So we'll see if they actually call this the end of the third quarter or whether there's one more play being called, and it looks like they will run one more play.
Okay, Kodiaks fans, I know that you can cheer, but I want to know if you can dance. Where do you have to sweat? DJ Dennis!
Reed Vankonit drops back to pass. Final play of the third quarter, and that falls incomplete. Evan Guizzo, the intended target, and that will bring the conclusion. Glad I waited for that one, but that will bring the conclusion of the third quarter. We'll take a moment to step away when we get back. Fourth quarter action here at Massage Place Stadium.
Collins Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds and 36-inch TVs. Suites also include a mini fridge and other kitchen appliances to make your stay as comfortable
as
possible.
Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium.
During your stay in Pilot Mound, visit Weiser's Restaurant, our attached family-friendly restaurant and bar.
The Kamloops Broncos facing a third and long, so they will be in a punting situation as Maurice Banks hovers around his own 5-yard line to get this fourth quarter, the final quarter, underway here in Prince George. The third and final matchup between these two clubs. We'll see if the Kamloops Broncos can hold on and make it a sweep of the Kodiaks in this 3-game season series. Jeeves punts this one away, gets a running start at it, and forces Banks back to his own 1-yard line. Banks finds a seam, fumbles it, and it looks as though the Broncos may have... No, the Kodiaks were lucky enough. Banks able to jump on his own fumble. Looks like he may have had a crease there, but someone managed to get a hand on the ball and break it loose to put a halt on Banks, who was just about to get the steam running on that steam engine. 14:36 remaining here in the fourth quarter, so Kodiak's able to jump on the loose ball to keep possession as their offense now comes out onto the field. Maurice Banks in the backfield. Oskowski in the shotgun. Hand off to Banks. Banks very quickly gets wrapped up by a sea of white in the backfield. Broncos forcing the tackle. May have been, looked as though Banks was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, but certainly a tough task to do. Perhaps the smallest player on the Prince George Kodiaks somehow coming up with enough strength to push the herd back to the line of scrimmage, and it forces second down for the Kodiaks. Oskowski calls out his cadence, drops back, looks, scans his receivers, looks to go for Ingram, who gets tripped up, and that is a flag pass interference being called against the Kamloops Broncos. As Ingram, trying to track down the ball, gets tripped up by a pair of Broncos defenders. So 13:40 remaining. This is just an 11-point game as the Kamloops Broncos hold on to a narrow lead. Just 3 field goals and a safety, a conceded safety, being the difference in this one, as it's been all Kamloops, but it's really been a fairly tight matchup between these two squads tonight here in Prince George. Oskowski calls his cadence, hands off to Noah Lank. Lank surges forward, tries to find a seam in the defense, but gets stacked up and wrapped up, brought down to the turf for a gain of about 4 yards. So it'll be third down for the Kodiaks, and the offense or sorry, it'll be second down, rather. So second and five. Oskowski in the shotgun. Three receivers set towards the short side of the field. Ball spotted on the near side hash mark. Oskowski drops back, scans left, connects to Noah Lank, and that will be enough for a first down to move the chains. 12:45 here in the fourth quarter. First and 10. Ball being spotted at the 53-yard line and on the near side hash mark. Kodiak's nearing midfield here. Oskowski takes a snap, hands off to Noah Lank. Lank runs and gains of about 3 yards on the play. So 12:10 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Ball now past midfield. It's about the 53-yard line on the opposite side, inside the Kamloops zone. Oskowski in the shotgun. Three receivers. Ball gets snapped. Oskowski connects with Jerome Erickson. There is a flag on the play. Looked to have been offside against the Broncos. The Kodiaks trying to come up with a free play, but half the offense was paying attention. The other half was too busy trying to gesture to the officials that a member of the Kamloops Broncos was offside. So Oskowski forced to just dump it off to Jerome Erickson in the flat. But instead, actually the officials say that there was no flag on the play. So that one comes back to bite the Kodiaks. So it'll be third down now. So Kodiaks throw a play away thinking that there was a flag against Kamloops. And instead, they're now facing a third down situation with their offense still out onto the field with 11:42 remaining here in the fourth quarter. And it looks as though the Kodiaks are deciding to go for it. They still have about 5 yards to go for the first down. Oskowski drops back, some pressure along the right side. Quick hit to Maurice Banks, who's still loose and gets brought down at about the 30-yard line inside the Kamloops end of the field. So a quick hit over the middle to Maurice Banks, and that gets the sticks moving as the Prince George Kodiaks come up with a first down, 11:28 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Oskowski in the shotgun, very quickly getting the play underway. Noah Lank heads towards the sideline, trying to find the edge. And he gets brought down by number five from the Kamloops Broncos, Avery Dunster. So the clock rolling here in the final quarter of play. Second and what looks to be about 6 yards. So a rumble of about 4 yards from Lank on the previous play. Second and six for the Kodiaks. Oskowski takes the snap, drops back, looks towards the sideline, and that falls incomplete. Kay Mitchell, the intended target on the far side of the field. He's unable to get enough of his mitts between the turf and the ball to bring that one in. Instead, it falls incomplete. 10:35 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Prince George faced with a third down situation. It looks as though they'll be bringing on the field goal unit. There's Noah Schneider. Will line up for a 35-yard field goal attempt. Ball is snapped, kick is up, and that is good. The Prince George Kodiaks get themselves up on the board. A 35-yard field goal attempt from Noah Schneider is good, and we've got ourselves an 11-3 bowl game here at Massage Play Stadium. We're going to take a quick break. When we get back, the Broncos will take over on offense.
I'm forcing this one. The offense is already out on the field, but they're going to take some time. So I'm hoping it lines up. Okay, let's hold it.
Welcome back. The Kamloops Broncos on offense as they snap the ball, hand off to Evan Guizzo, who runs towards the right side of the formation, towards the sideline, and gets brought out inside the Kodiak sideline. Looks as though he may have had enough to rumble for a first down to move the chains, and that he does as the chains are moving on the far side of the field. 9:42 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Noah Schneider coming up with a 35-yard field goal for the Kodiaks to get themselves on the board late in this one. And he brings it narrowed to an 11-3 score in favor of the Kamloops Broncos. But the Broncos on offense, ball spotted at the 46-yard line on the near side hash mark. Broncos looking to move the ball, broadcast left to right here at Massage Place Stadium. Reed Van Conant, the quarterback, drops back, looks for a quick hit, but he decides to tuck it and runs upfield. Gain of about 8 yards on the play. Van Conant with a little quick pump towards the sideline, trying to fake out the defense, open up the middle. He runs for about 7 yards on the play as it's second down now. Ball spotted, 52-yard line, near side hash mark. Van Conant, handoff to Guizzo. Guizzo rumbles towards the left side and gets brought down by the defense. Maybe a yard on the play. And that will bring up third down for the Broncos as they near midfield. And it looks as though the punt team will be coming out onto the field for Kamloops. 8:20 remaining here in the fourth quarter as Keon Raymond Jr. goes back to receive this punt. The ball spotted at the 54-yard line, just inside the far side hash mark here at Massage Place Stadium. The Kodiaks will be looking for something from their offense from here on out as they find themselves down by a narrow score. The Broncos currently leading 11-3. Zach Cormier took a knee following the play. Training staff came out, but he was able to run off unassisted. As though he might just be looking for a little bit of a breather. As the Broncos punt team breaks the huddle. 8 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter. Jeeves will punt this one away, run up and end-over-end punt. Keon Raymond receives it at his 20-yard line, tries to find an edge, does some dancing. And that does not work out for Keon Raymond Jr., who maybe gets a few yards on the return and gets brought down as the Kodiaks offense will take to the field. 7:41 remaining here in the fourth quarter, which is brought to you by Treasure Cove Casino.
Still looking for our first major of the game. The Kodiaks are starting deep in their own territory.
We're nearly reaching the midway mark of the fourth quarter, and we've yet to see any touchdowns scored from either side. An 11-3 score in favor of Kamloops. Oskowski drops back, rolls to his right, some pressure from his right side. A fumble on the play, and the Kamloops Broncos leap on that. As number five comes up with the fumble recovery, Avery Dunster celebrating towards the stands here in Prince George, and some celebration out of the Broncos as they head towards the sidelines. Some perhaps over-the-top celebration, I might add, just given the fact it's 11-3 here, and we'll see whether the Broncos are able to come up with the first major in tonight's matchup as the Broncos take over on offense at the 20-yard line. A little play action from Vankonit, who looks towards the end zone. Falls incomplete, but flags in the end zone as looks like two Broncos receivers just had black and gold draped all over them. Will likely be a pass interference penalty against the Kodiaks, which will push the Broncos right up against the goal line, likely, depending on the penalty being called. .646 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Reed Vankonit, quarterback for Kamloops, rushes into the huddle coming from the sideline. We'll go first and goal from the 5-yard line. Ball gets snapped. Vankonit, play action, looks towards the end zone. Ball goes up, and that ball's incomplete. Keon Raymond right there to force the incompletion. Curtis Pearson, number 83, was the intended target for Vankonit. And it brings up second and goal for the Broncos. 6:22 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Broncos looking to get this one out of reach. Despite the narrow score or low scoring affair we've had tonight, we've yet to see a major scored, and Evan Guizzo gets the handoff and gets brought down behind the line of scrimmage. And that will bring up third down. Inside 6 minutes. Broncos offense heads towards the sideline. The field goal team will come out for Kamloops, and they'll go for their fourth field goal attempt in tonight's matchup. Be a 12-yard field goal attempt for the Broncos. We'll see if the Kodiaks can get some pressure up the middle. 5:15 remaining here in the fourth quarter. The ball gets placed, ball goes up, and that is good. Number 29, Cohen Fries, with his fourth field goal in tonight's matchup, a perfect 4 for 4. It's now 14-3 for the Broncos. The strong defensive front from the Kodiaks to force a third down, but the Broncos close enough to the end zone to come up with a field goal to make this an 11-point game. 5:03 remaining in the fourth quarter. As the Kodiaks offense out onto the field, they break the huddle. Kodiaks will take the ball at the 35-yard line, near side hash mark. Oskowski drops back little quick hit to Noah Schneider out of the backfield. He gets brought down. Number three with the tackle, Abe Fimbo. We got 4:50 remaining in the fourth quarter. Time very quickly running out, escaping Prince George. As the Broncos hold on to an 11-point lead. Strong defensive performance from either side, but it's been some key plays that have allowed the Broncos to get inside scoring range, resulting in four field goals for themselves. Oskalski drops back out of the shotgun, looks over the middle, wide open, Noah Legg, and there it is. Noah Legg comes up with a big reception to bring it in past midfield, and that gets the Kodiaks down to the Kamloops 40-yard line. With 4:15 remaining here in the fourth quarter. The offense very quickly, no huddle at this point. With so little time to move, a big connection wide open. Noah Legg found a seam, a break, a gap in the secondary. Oskalski drops back, first down. A quick connection to Maurice Banks towards the sideline as they move the ball. A gain of about 6 yards. Brings up second and four. 4:05 remaining in the fourth quarter. Kodiaks with the ball now at the 34-yard line. Second and four. Just need to get to the 30-yard line for a fresh set of downs. Ball spotted on the far side hash mark. Trips right formation on the weak side of the field. Jerome Erickson, slot receiver on the strong side. Oskalski drops back, looks towards the sideline, finds Kay Mitchell, and he runs out of bounds. First down for the Kodiaks, and they're moving the ball with 3:44 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Oskalski running a no-huddle offense, and they will huddle up following that one. With Kay Mitchell running out of bounds, stopping the clock. First and 10. Oskalski in the shotgun. Will hand the ball off to Schneider. Schneider will rush up. Gets close to the 15-yard line. I believe he'll get marked at the 16. So 3:10 in the fourth quarter. Ball spotted. What looks, it may be just a smack dab between the 16 and 17-yard line. In between the hash marks. Oskalski in the shotgun. Schneider in the backfield with him. He'll pass protect. Schneider, Oskalski steps up. Tucks it himself. Tries to get some yardage and he'll bring the ball very close to the 10-yard line. And it'll be third and short. And the Kodiaks will bring in the jumbo package. Oskalski will come off. Quinn Newcomb in at quarterback. We'll have Jason Kratt, Corbin Brown, and Cade Coyle bring in the beef on offense as they'll try to go for a short yardage play. They are just inches short. Or it'll be second and short, I will say. And actually, the officials will actually converge and they'll decide to bring out the sticks, looking for a measurement to see whether the Kodiaks indeed have a first down. So we'll leave you hanging, actually. We'll take a quick break. We'll step away, a quick 30-second break coming up. Welcome back. I left you hanging, but it will be third and short for the Kodiaks as the measurement did not come in favor of Prince George. Slight delay as the officials spot the ball and get this play whistled in. Quinn Newcomb in at quarterback. He'll line up under center. Noah Lank, Noah Schneider, and Jason Kratt in the backfield. Newcomb rushes, plunges forward, and that will be a Prince George Kodiaks first down, and it will be first and goal for Prince George. So Newcomb comes in, short yardage, comes up with the first down, and gives the Kodiaks a fresh set of downs just inside the 10-yard line. Ball spotted on the 9-yard line. As Oskowski and his crew will come back out onto the field. Oskowski in the shotgun, trips right formation. You've got Evan Ingram and Jerome Erickson on the weak side here. And it'll be a play action, a little dump to Jerome Erickson, who's trying to find some room. He plunges towards the goal line. And what will it be? It'll be just short, it looks like. Kodiaks trying to gesture for a touchdown, but not sure what the call is, and it looks like it will be just short. So once again, the jumbo package coming in for the Prince George Kodiaks. And Quinn Newcomb, a touchdown last week in a very similar formation, comes in at quarterback. He's under center. And he'll plunge forward, and that is a touchdown! Quinn Newcomb plunges forward to get the Kodiaks on the board with a major. And that narrows this one. So with the touchdown, the Prince George Kodiaks narrow the lead. Broncos leading 14-9, and it looks like Prince George is going to go for two. Oskowski comes in for the two-point convert with 1:46 remaining. Good or not, we can anticipate the Kodiaks likely potentially go for an onside. Oskowski drops back, decides to throw, and that gets swatted down and away by number 15 of the Kamloops Broncos, Jack Bellefontaine, and that two-point convert falls incomplete. So 14-9 in favor of the Broncos. The Kodiaks will draw something up, but we will step away for a quick break.
Well, it looks like we've been short of that two-point conversion.
Welcome back to Massage Place Stadium, where the Prince George Kodiaks are lining up to kick the ball away. Kickoff brought to you by DMC Chartered Accountants, following the one-yard plunge from Quinn Newcomb in the short yardage play to give us the first major in tonight's matchup. The Kodiaks still trailing the Kamloops Broncos by a score of 14-9. Schneider, with the ball placed, will kick this one away. Looks for a little squib kick, and that goes in favor of the Kodiaks. Matthew Uriah K. Mitchell with the onside kick recovery as he just soared like Jordan to bring that one in. And the Kodiaks retain the ball, and their offense will go on back out onto the field. My apologies, it was actually Nick Tremblay that came up with the hops. Both him and Kay Mitchell, both jersey numbers end in 7, both have long sleeve white shirts on, so apologies for the mishap, but regardless, the Prince George Kodiaks come up with the ball and their offense is back out onto the field with the ball spotted now at the 46-yard line. 1:43 remaining, the Kodiaks down by 5. Oskowski takes the snap, hands off to Noah Lang, plunges forward, gets stood up, wrapped up, and gets whistled down. Be a gain of a few. Looks to be a gain of about 3 or 4 yards on the play, so we'll bring up second down. 1:37 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Oskowski in the shotgun. Second down play, takes the snap, drops back, scans to his left, tries to roll, gets wrapped up, and brought down by the Broncos defense.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Liam Oskowski can take
Maurice Onyemenu coming up with the sack, number 16 for the Broncos. And the Kodiaks will call a timeout with 1:25 remaining. So we will step away. More fourth quarter action coming up after this. Kodiaks trying to go deep on the play, and that falls incomplete. Jerome Erickson, the intended target, but there is a flag in the backfield on the third down play. And it will be going against the Kamloops Broncos. So a big penalty being called against the Kamloops Broncos. That will bring up an automatic first down for the Kodiaks as that will push the ball. So the Kodiaks sideline gesturing towards the crowd, trying to keep them quiet. So first and 10 for the Kodiaks. Ball spotted at the 29-yard line. Kodiak sideline very quick to hush the crowd, and some thumbs up coming from number 3, Matthew Watson, as a job well done by the crowd to hush up. Oskowski in the shotgun. Drops back, looks to his right, connects to Keon Raymond, but that goes through his gloves, and that will be second and 10 now for the Kodiaks. So second and 10. Ball spotted at the 29-yard line. Oskowski in the shotgun. Noah Lank lone back in the backfield. Oskowski will take the snap, drop back, connect, and that skips off the turf. Some miscommunication between Evan Ingram and Jerome Erickson as the two cross paths and pass attempt falls incomplete. That brings up third down with just over a minute, 1:08 remaining in the fourth quarter with the Broncos leading 14-9. Broncos trying to hold on and bring up their third win against the Prince George Kodiaks this season and back-to-back wins. Oskowski drops back, takes the snap, scanning, looking, trying to find a receiver, connects to Jared Annis, and that is completed. A little bit of a bobble, and he comes up with the reception. Broncos trying to gesture that it was incomplete, but Annis able to hold on. And it looks like that may have been short, though. So a completed catch, but that forces a turnover with the Kodiaks unable to get a first down on third down. And the Broncos will take over with 59.2 seconds remaining on the clock. A disappointing end to the offensive drive there. An unfortunate way to wrap up as the Kodiaks were looking to piece together a scoring drive or at least had momentum in their corner. But there's still time on the clock. So the Kodiaks defense back out. Reed Van Kunit looking to shut this one down as he hands off to Evan Guizzo. Guizzo gets wrapped up. And that brings the clock down to 54.8 seconds. On the score clock. It'll be timeout for Prince George with 54.8. Kamloops Broncos currently ahead 14-9, so we will take a quick 30-second break. Welcome back. The crowd is loud. Van Kunit takes the snap. Hands off to Evan Guizzo. He gets wrapped up and brought down. And that brings up third down. Clock down to 49 seconds. Still time on the clock. Third and 7 for the Kamloops Broncos. And that brings out the punt team. So a quick two and out forced by the Kodiaks defense. And this one is coming right down to the wire here at Massage Place Stadium between these two sides. The Kamloops Broncos looking for their third victory to sweep the Kodiaks on the season series. Back-to-back wins, 3-0 in the series, but the Kodiaks are hanging on, trying to come up with their second win of the season. As Keon Raymond Jr. back to receive the punt, lined up at his own 47-yard line. It seems to be some delay, and it will be a timeout being called by Kamloops. So we might as well just take another break and keep you holding on to figure out how this one concludes here at Massage Place Stadium. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Welcome back. Are you still listening? We hope you are. The Kamloops Broncos punt this one away end over end, but the short punt, and that will be a no yards call against Kamloops. And some extracurriculars between members of the Kodiaks and the Kamloops Broncos. So a no yards call, the initial call against the Kodiaks, and then there's some extracurriculars away from the play between a member of the Kodiaks and a member of the Broncos, which results in another flag being thrown. So we'll have to wait to see how this one gets called by the officials. We've got 21.4 seconds remaining. The ball has been spotted at the 40-yard line.
Well, we got penalties against both the Broncos and the Kodiaks, and it would appear that they're going to sort of cancel themselves out. It is Kodiak's ball.
So no yards play, or no yards call, and I believe an unnecessary roughness being called against the Kodiaks. So the two penalties cancel each other out. Kodiaks offense comes out onto the field, and we've got 21.4 seconds remaining with the Kodiaks down by five. Oskowski in the shotgun, calls his cadence, drops back to pass, looks over the middle, connects with Jerome Erickson, and that is good. Brings the ball down to the 20-yard line. 17.3 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter, and the Kodiaks get themselves a first down. Brings the ball down to the 20-yard line. Oskowski, very quick, takes the snap, drops back, looks over the middle, looks for the end zone, rings it off the crossbar. Just making this one even more dramatic. 6.8 seconds on the clock, second and 10. Ball spotted at the 20-yard line. Kodiaks down by five. What else do I have to say to get you entertained in this one? Kodiaks break the huddle. Oskowski calls his cadence, drops back, looks to pass, scans, rolls a little bit to his left, rolling even more, looks over the middle, connects to number 19, Evan Ingram, brings it inside the 10 with the clock down to reading zeros. Kamloops celebrating.
Complete to Jerome Erickson again, and he is down on the field.
And a little bit of a delay as the clock is reading zero, and that is the ball game. The Kamloops Broncos go on to win 14-9 against the Prince George Kodiaks, and this one comes right down to the wire. As the Kamloops Broncos complete the season sweep against the Prince George Kodiaks for a perfect 3-0 on the season series. Broncos improve to a 4-4 record as their chase for the playoffs continues. The Prince George Kodiaks, they fall. With two games remaining, they stand with a 1-7 record. We will have the post-game show coming up after this break.
And we do ask that if you have been by this evening, that you find yourself a safe ride home. The Kodiaks want to see you back at our next home game.